Hi, it's Leslie Meredith with ITE. I'm here at Africa Oil Week, and in the studio with me this afternoon is Mohammed from Gulf Reservoir Technology. Okay, great. And he's with us, has joined us from Abu Dhabi. Welcome.
Thank you so much.
All right. Tell us a little bit about your company and how that ties in with this afternoon's topic of local content.
Okay, our company started around 15 years ago. We do consulting, training, and recruitment in the fields of upstream and downstream. That includes petroleum engineering, geoscientists, and then the downstream electrical, mechanical, chemical, and other engineering, and technicians and operators. So we train people on how to become an effective national workforce. And we do short-term training and long-term training. Sometimes it reaches to like 2 years. We did a lot of projects for West, North, and South Africa. We are very well known in the Middle East. And we have 5 offices, one in Iraq, one in Qatar, one in UAE, and that is the main office, and one in Algeria, and the last one is in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia.
So we've certainly had some difficult times the last few years, a lot of projects getting put on hold, but I'm hearing some optimism at the conference this year. And with you being sort of on the leading edge, you might see the beginnings of an upturn sooner than a lot of others. How do you feel about that?
That's absolutely correct. We all felt the pain in the last 2.5-3 years. And when oil price started to go down and then dramatically went down, and even it picked up and reached to something like 50, but still the business is not as before. So from my experience, we have been in the same depression 3 times before, but it never lasts for 2 and 3 years like what's happening these days. Since, I will say, last July, we start to pick up. We as a service company doing training and consulting, we start to see tenders, we start to receive phone calls and emails asking, can you do this, can you do that? The companies, the major companies, and national and international, have some budget for the second, the third, and fourth quarter of this year. So everybody felt that it is going to come back, and I was showing in my talk today a histogram showing the number of participants in our company, and it goes up all the way till 2008, reach a maximum, and then goes down during the depression in 2009, and then it picks up again, reach it to unbelievable high numbers in 2014, down in 15, almost nothing in 16. So for this year, I think we are putting our foot on the first step of going back to the high. I think it's not going to reach to the same level as it was before, more than 100, but I think we are going to get heads the 60s and the 70s maybe by mid-2018.
Okay, well, that's pretty good news. Is this your first time at Africa Oil Week?
No, this is my fourth time. I'm a regular presenter here in the local content, so I always present every year.
Oh, well, that's good to hear. So how would you characterize the importance of the show to the industry?
To be honest, I have 4 conferences that I go to every single year for the last 10 years. I didn't hear about this conference before, but in 2013 was the first time I visited. And then 14, 15, 16, and 17, I presented to in the local contents. I think, if not the best, it is one of the best organized conferences, international conferences in the field of oil and gas industry. The people are working so hard, so well to get it look like what it is right now. That's why it's attracting people, and the number of participants are increasing annually. So I think they are in the right way.
Great, and we're so happy that you're a part of it. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for inviting me for this.